It's been a minute. It's been a minute since I've been on this thing. But guess what? I'm back on this thing. I had my little daughter. She's amazing. New life in the world. You know what I'm saying? We're happy. So guess what? We're about to get it cracking back on this Madden. You know what I mean? How's everybody doing today? It's your boy Gaming with Celeb. You know the streaming beaming is back. You know what I mean? Hopefully I can get my peoples on here. You know what I'm saying? Where y'all at? Where my peoples at, man? Where y'all at? Where y'all at? You feel me? Get back on this thing with your boy one time. You know what I mean? Glad to be back, man. Now it's time to really get on some of this streaming shit and really make some money, man. Get some memberships going and some shit cracking, you feel me? Where y'all at? I'm saying... Don't forget to hit that like button for me, that subscribe button for me one time. I do got a super chat. I got memberships, all that shit. You know what I'm saying? Hit me up one time. Hit your boy up one time. You know what I'm saying? We about to get it in on some of this Madden, though. You know what I'm saying? You know what's happening. Madden. Got 2K coming on a little later. You know what I mean? I like shit. We in the preseason, you know what I mean? I really don't like playing preseason games, but I'll get all my, you know, all my training and shit in. Right now, we got the Colts. Yeah, we done moved some teams. You know what I'm saying? So, hopefully it goes well for us. Shit. I really don't. Yeah, for this one here. Ooh, catching in traffic, huh? We'll do that. We'll work that on now. Oh, why I do that? we don't need that. There we go. I feel like I think I need to go and create me like a playbook for the way that I play. So I'm gonna go and create a fucking playbook. You know what I'm saying? See what I got there. These new puppies up in here, man, I gotta keep my eye on their little ass, man. Hell no. No strong. Yes. Nothing from weak, but we need to go with that shotgun. But sugar down, we need to go with shotgun. Maybe bring a little single back up in there. Trying to figure single back strong. I just need to go with I form. Fuck it. Come on, the I formation. Three, four for sure. 3-4.
It's week one of the National Football League, and we've got a showdown in the AFC South. It's the Titans and the Colts on Sunday Night Primetime.
I mean, here we go. We're about to do this, Tennessee. It's my third season. Third year.
It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Tonight, it's the Sunday night opener for the new NFL season between the Tennessee Titans and the Indianapolis Colts.
The next year, there was a whole bunch of different free agents picking them all up. I'm playing with multiple teams, but my main two teams are the Panthers.
With my good friend Charles Davis in the booth, I'm Brandon Gaudin, and the moment. Brandon Gunn with my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. CD, you look at the Titans in this matchup. Their offense is a unit that's not afraid to take chances out there, but not always for the better. What do you see them trying to do here?
I think they'll continue to take those chances, Brandon, but to me, they have to do it in a measured way. And what I mean by that,
quarterback out there.
They can't just come into a game and throw caution to the wind and just say, we're going to run a bunch of gadget plays, a lot of reverses, end arounds, all of those things. They've got to identify the spots where they want those plays to pay off, which means you have to set them up.
Great
and
ball.
Then when they present themselves, take full advantage.
Right to the air. Here's and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Here's second and 7 now from the 28. Goff. Looking for and down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on, catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Goff on third down. Open man is Tanner. 45 before being tackled. 16 yards to pick up there. The Colts have a first down.
I'm not sure that was necessarily a safety valve or a check down throw. Third down, sometimes just try and find the open guy and get him the ball. He did exactly that and found a way to pick up a first down.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Chances are good. He's going to be a very busy guy. Two catches already in his opening drive, and they were looking his way for a third.
I think they put this defense on notice that that could be a really, really frequent combination. Throw caught by Pierce. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Titans 40. Another good reception there. The Colts on the march. Now the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far in the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
They'll run. This is Jonathan Taylor. 35. Good for a gain of 5.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. Third and 6. Here's Goff. And the Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes. T.J. Watt, the All-Pro, in there to take him down. So that time, Charles, a quarterback helplessly in the pocket in the face of a pass rush like that. They were on him instantly.
And this came from the edge, and those pass rushers have so many tricks of the trade to get around blockers. They have a lot of tools in their kit. This was pure speed and athleticism on this play, though. And they could barely get a glove on him before he got the quarterback on the ground.
As we check the next-gen stats, you'll see he had precious little time to do anything with the football there. First and 10 now, Willis and the Titans at their own 18.
Ready.
Huh. success, 19 yards. And this, I mean, it's certainly something to watch out for. He is not afraid to call his own number on plays like that, and here he takes it for good yardage.
And we know this defense prepared all week for this, but sometimes when you see it in person, it's a whole different ball game, and all that preparation, it goes right out the window.
Another nice gain. That's now 30 yards between those last two plays. But one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they're in sync, as we're seeing so far, with that continuity there, you can see the defensive front linebackers. You're exactly right. It'll be a very solid defense. Because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
Well, they've been back on their heels a little bit here in this drive, but a chance to exhale just a little bit there with incompletion on first down. Now they have to gear up, try and get two more stops and escape this drive. Step aside here in this first quarter. And for the Colts, an extra defensive back in there now on third down.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about. And you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it, and oftentimes, take it away.
It's called for and made right at the 25-yard line. Officially just 27 yards there on the punt. And the Colts will go on offense here, first and 10.
Change up the game plan
a
little
bit. Team is out there now, and
just a little bit. Just a little bit.
Away.
Ain't got to do too much.
Out inside the 27. The Titans coming back onto the field for their second drive. And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are matching up this early, or would you prefer a game like this be a few weeks down the road?
You to see that the entire offseason and know, hey, right out of the gate, we're playing a division game. Second part is it spreads them out a little bit. If you just have them all bunched up at the end of the year, that's not as much fun watching teams try to survive that gauntlet. You have injuries down the stretch.
Get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Got to keep that up.
Here's Willis. Oh, going for Jefferson. Inside the 20. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line.
But he reminded us that he was a 1,000-yard receiver a year ago as he starts off week one picking up right where he left off. For a big year, he just gave us excellent evidence of his belief.
What a difference a play makes. A huge step forward and now a small step back as he loses a yard or two. So after the loss of a yard, they'll look to push forward here on second down and 11. Completed the pass but lost yardage, so they'll decline the penalty.
Perfect play for them, isn't it? Who needs a penalty when you try and throw the ball, you don't even get it downfield, and they go ahead and snuff out the play. They'll take that as a result.
Tough spot, needing 11 yards to pick up the first. Throwing on third, Goff. He takes this one down almost all the way to the 30.
Are you kidding me?
Play that turns out to be 36 yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? Nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Now it's gone. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. To throw is gone. That's complete to his running back. Taken down here just shy of the 30.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it could turn into a big game downfield. What a nice job they did getting to him quickly.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Multiple players getting home there, and it's a loss of 2 on the sack.
Well, that's the second time he's been sacked so far in the first half, and if they have designs on having a big year, on going anywhere, they've got to find a way to keep him upright so he can throw the football.
But we got to fucking score.
And his kick is absolutely perfect. And that will extend their lead even further.
Against everybody.
Charles A. Carrillo.
Well, we did watch him in pregame, and he hit from this distance. So not a surprise, but there still is something exciting about it, carrying it over from practice and pregame to actually doing it in live action.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And last time they coughed it up, led to a field goal. They're fortunate that it only led to a field goal, but still, they're not happy about it.
Could you sense the relief, though, when they only gave up the field goal? And every other drop back out on the field is I think Coach would be ecstatic to see them pick themselves back up and now take it downfield, punching the end zone without turning it over.
Looking lost out there, bro.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know this is a true weapon attack, especially against the big body guys in the middle of this team. This has got to be priority one. Certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away.
Kick catching up there.
Football 101, you've got to let the guy catch the ball.
You have to know the ball is there. You have to know it's arrived. Otherwise, you're going to get flagged every time.
Now it's first and 10 after a costly penalty there on fourth down. From the 50, it's off. He'll check this one down. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down.
When I pressed the trigger down, it made my dude completely stop.
And it'll be second down.
Oh, God. Hit L2. I got completely stopped. Get
it inside the 35, just shy of the 30. 96 yards rushing for him in his first half as he is looking in mid-season form here in the opener.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Goff on first down.
Yo, why my guy stop?
Jacoby Myers, 32 yards. And the Colts are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. Extra point right down the middle. And that makes our score 17-0. The Colts kicking team is out there now, and they will send this one away. Here's Tennessee ready to begin this drive offensively. And we don't want to call this desperation time, especially in the second quarter, but you're down.
You don't
down,
want to.
No, but hold on, let me finish.
Okay, my bad.
And you're down three scores already. You've done nothing offensively. Nothing on the scoreboard. That's not a good combination. You know, you're going to be making this one desperation time. But I know you did. But let's face it, you mentioned this to me.
This is all they've been doing the whole game. Every time I get some juice going, hold it. Hold it. Come on, man.
So it's the big left tackle who gets tagged with a hold.
And sometimes you're actually executing the block well, and he starts to slip off of you, and instinctively you reach out and grab him. And with stuff like that, it's hard to see.
Why did I do that?
I
went to press X and press square thinking I'm on fucking Xbox.
The scoreboard tells a story for a moving play. It was not quite desperation time yet.
Third and 16, but they get the conversion anyway.
that game.
Maybe trying to get a jump start on that route.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right about that. And
Lindbergh is going home, man.
Changing hands here as this offense takes a field. Charles, they'd be fine with more of the same on this upcoming drive. Last time out, they found the end zone for six. Certainly hoping for the game plan. Because I think this offense is ready to break out some new wrinkles and try some new things that might be hidden in their playbook. They want to use that confidence to its advantage while also keeping the defense from anticipating what's up next. Now Goff on first down.
It's covered.
And he wisely will throw it.
He got an all-dated pro, too.
Not only did he have a chance to scan the field there, felt like he had a chance to scan it twice. The protection was that good. Unfortunately for him, the coverage downfield, equally good.
Throwing again on second and 10. Goff.
Time.
Boy, a big play right there. I mean, a touchdown on this drive could have really put some separation
all day.
On the scoreboard. Instead, it's the defense who scores. And partner, we got a game again.
And we do have one because of what you just described. The defense that understood
never over.
What was going on in this game and did something about it. They knew their offense needed some help. They just provided it. They're back in this one.
Extra point by Carlson, up and good. And that'll cut the lead to 17-7. So
right
they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. This is the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. Here comes the Indianapolis offense now as they get set to take over. And it's still plenty of time remaining here in the half, more than a minute. We'll see if they just want to protect that lead or try to add on to it.
Well, with as much time as is left on the clock, I would imagine it would be the latter. I think they're going to try and add on to it. So what they're going to tell the team is very simply, if you can get out of bounds after making a play downfield, terrific. If you can't, everyone hustle to the line of scrimmage, either run another play or clock it and start over again.
He'll take a shot down for Pittman.
No, sir.
And that will be incomplete.
No, sir.
Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
Early on, the running game's been working well. The offensive line has been pleased by that. The thought process there, catch those safeties creeping up, trying to help against the running game. They tried to hit them over the top, unsuccessfully.
On second and 10, Goff.
Stay inside. Good job.
Now the Colts gonna
keep him inside.
Don't
let him run out of bounds.
We're going to
screen.
Go ahead. Was, with a little over 50 seconds
try to get
to
over there, man. I played
the
Tampa 2. You're supposed to be over there.
And an extra defensive back out there for the Titans now here for third down. Now Goff. And that will be incomplete.
I'm so glad he overthrew
him. Scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. On fourth down, on is the punter, Colby Wideman.
I'm so glad he overthrew him, y'all.
Titan football. The Titans going to go back on offense here late in this first half. Well, not much time remains here in this first half. We'll see if they can get something out of this drive, at least a field goal. They could certainly use it. Down by two scores. Here on the first down run as he takes this forward for about six. 6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four.
Going on, fam. Hey, you got the PlayStation 5, man. Get on, nigga.
They hurry, we'll see.
This bullshit and playing this damn piece, this fucking computer. Get on this shit, bro. You ain't even got me, man. Add me. You ain't even add me. Add me on the PlayStation 5.
So we've reached half. All right, we will save the week one highlights and apparently get right back to the action here in the third.
I'm going to run inside on that ass still. He ain't been really doing it, but it's been that. Definitely that short pass.
And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. We'll see if week one fatigue becomes indicative. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Titans getting set to go here to begin the third quarter. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they've got some time. The running game strong in the first half. Opposition knows how to focus on defending the pass here. Maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
An excellent way to start the drive there, 18 yards. Pretty ideal right there. Keep it yourself, get the first down, and get the heck out of bounds.
And knowing him, I believe he's thinking, I'd get a few more yards if I just lower my shoulder. But he also hears that second voice in his head, his head coach, or probably his agent too, saying, get out of bounds, man, don't do that.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10.
All right, I'm gonna fix that right now.
Just a terrific run there, Charles, from a running back who is so compact and powerful, and that strength was on display there.
And with a guy his size, you have to know defensively that arm tackles aren't gonna fly with him. You have to be able to wrap up, or else he can just brush tacklers aside like they're not even there.
And the next gen stats shows us the tale of how much yardage he was able to pick up after the initial contact.
Alright, let's see if it worked now. Let's see if that worked. I can't be hearing it. I don't be really hearing nothing because I don't have it on. Unless I put it in the background. Let's see if that fixed it.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine.
That's a wide open. Let's go.
Yards on the pickup.
Every time.
Looking to throw, holding on the big right tackle.
That's real simple, partner. Keep your hands inside in the chest area. You're probably okay. You get it out on the shoulders, get them wide. Usually got to pick up a holding call.
One down to about the 40.
Not a ton of room available on that one, but he made use of what space was available and gained decent yardage.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Off the play fake. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
We know play callers can be very creative in this game today, but sometimes when they've got receivers with speed like this, they don't need to design incredibly complex calls. Sometimes it's just get the ball in his hands and let him do his thing. In a sense, less can become more,
definitely.
And it was right there.
First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back.
Yeah, man,
into
I
this
don't know what the
game.
Fuck, man. I'm probably about to restart my screen. Starting here. Reset everything.
That's going to wind up a loss of 3 yards on first down.
But we saw a lot of negative plays that resulted in plenty of lost yardage in the first
that's
half.
That's annoying. I can hear it right now, too. Here. I can hear it on my little, phone I got playing right here now. I can hear that shit being shit buzzing.
Oh my God! Why did I press X?
Have it here at their own 15.
I meant to press the X, and I pressed square, thinking I'm on Xbox. He was wide open up here. That's my fucking fault, man. Playing two different systems with the X button.
Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
The Colts come to the line, ready to start their next drive. And their defense just helped him out by getting the through with points on their first possession.
And that's a big one for them because after the work the defense.
So I'm about to restart this whole shit, man.